All he ever wanted to be was a doctor. But when circumstances conspired to keep him out of medical school, Julius Axelrod found himself shunted down a road that led to unimaginable success and stardom as a scientist.
Oh yeah, the quirks of how your life turns out sometimes.
Julius Axelrod, known to one and all as Julie, was born into the tenements of New York City's Lower East Side on May 30th, 1912. In school, he developed a liking for history, literature, and science with an eye toward medical school. But after receiving his B.S. degree in biology from the City College of New York, Julie Axelrod couldn't get into medical school. To make matters worse, it was the height of the Depression, and he had a tough time just finding a job. Eventually, though, Axelrod landed a job with the New York City Health Department, testing vitamins that were added to milk and other foods. During a decade plus working there, he lost his left eye in a laboratory accident, got married, and took night classes at New York University to earn his master's in chemistry. While at the NYC Health Department's Laboratory of Industrial Hygiene, Axelrod was asked to help find why some non-aspirin pain relievers triggered a severe blood disorder in the people who took them. It was a serendipitous request that propelled him to a life-changing discovery.
One thing I learned is to ask the right questions at the right time and later to devised methods to answer these questions.
Axelrod teamed with an experienced researcher, Dr. Bernard Brody, who became his mentor. Julie quickly learned that a compound called aniline could cause the blood disorder patients were experiencing, so he suspected that the body was transforming a chemical in the pain relievers into aniline, and he suspected that the main ingredient in the pain relievers, acetanilid, was the culprit.
Within a few weeks, I developed a method to detect aniline in the blood and the urine. And I took some acid aniline and I found aniline in my urine. I knew I could do research just in that short time. It was a very unconventional way to do it. I knew how to answer these questions.
During that research, Axelrod found that another byproduct of acetanilid, a compound called N-acetylpiaminophenol, or acetaminophen for short, was a very effective pain reliever in its own right.
We suggested that instead of using acetanilid, which formed the toxic aniline, that this compound N-acetylpiaminophenol should be used.
That was 1948, and more than two decades would pass before Johnson & Johnson took Axelrod's findings, lifted the name Tylenol from N-acetylpiaminophenol, and thanks to a massive advertising campaign, created one of the best-selling pain relievers in the world.
We had no idea of its impact and its practical and economic impact. We didn't get a penny for any of this.
In 1949, Axelrod left New York for the Maryland countryside, joining the National Heart Institute, which was part of the newly formed National Institutes of Health in Bethesda, Maryland. But in such a fertile research setting, Axelrod knew that without a PhD, his opportunities for advancement would be limited. So in 1954, Julie took a leave of absence from NIH, and a year later received his doctorate from the George Washington University. Back at NIH, Dr. Axelrod left the Heart Institute for a key position within the Laboratory of Clinical Science at the National Institute of Mental Health. And within 2 years was immersed in research that focused on the activity of neurotransmitter hormones. It would become his most famous work and directly led to the development of a new class of antidepressant medications, especially selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, such as Prozac.
My greatest satisfaction was that I was involved in the treatment, the relief of pain, suffering of depression.
In 1970, Dr. Axelrod was awarded the Nobel Prize in Medicine or Physiology for discoveries concerning the humoral transmitters in the nerve terminals and the mechanisms for their storage, release, and inactivation.
Felt great. But, you know, the purpose of doing medical research is not to have fun in the lab, but to produce a treatment and a cure. That's the ultimate purpose, and this is what happened.
Dr. Axelrod continued to pursue active research until his formal retirement in 1984, and in 1996 was named Scientist Emeritus of the National Institutes of Health.